Hello students, welcome to the class. So in our previous class we have completed the chapter, second chapter of geography, that is land, soil and water resources. And in our today's class we are going to start the question and answer of this chapter. There are 10 question and answer and you have to cut question number 7 and question number 8. Now see the question number 1. How can we deal with water pollution? And your answer is? Your answer is given on page number 14, first paragraph. Water pollution can be controlled by treating industrial and domestic waste suitably before dumping them into water bodies. Natural pesticides and fertilizers should be used because many chemicals present in the synthetic ones are non-biodegradable. They are washed into drinking water sources by surface runoff. They accumulate in the bodies of organisms causing various health problems. They can be removed from water bodies only by distillation, which involves boiling the water and considering stem. So this was your answer number 1. Now see the next question, question number 2. What do you understand by pattern of land use? Explain with an example why pattern changes. Draw a table to show how India's land is used. And your answer is? So your answer is given on page number 9, fourth paragraph. Starting from this point, the pattern of land use may also change as it available technology changes. For example, a mineral-rich area used for agriculture or housing in the absence of mining technology may be converted into a mine with suitable technologies became available. Soon, factories may be built in the area and gradually more and more land may be put to industrial use. And after this, when you complete writing down these questions, after this, you have to draw the table which was given on your page number 15, this table. Okay, this is a distribution table of land. Okay, you have to draw this table after this paragraph. You have to write firstly this point and then draw this table. Land is the most basic resource as we live on it. The pattern of land use depends on the characteristics of the land. Land use pattern changes over time with changes in the need of people. Arable land, forest land, pasture and other unproductive land. Okay. Now see the next question. Now see question number 3. What are multi-purpose project river valley projects? And your answer is? Your answer is given on page number 11, third paragraph. You have to write whole paragraph. Okay. Rivers are one of the major sources of water. Projects undertaken to utilize river water efficiently usually involve the construction of dams and reservoirs for storing water and canals for diverting water and crop fields. Most of these projects simultaneously serve several projects like irrigation, flood control and production of hydroelectricity. They are known as multi-purpose river valley projects. This was your answer number 3. Now see the next question. Your next question is, mention 3 ways of saving water. And your answer is? Your answer is given on page number 14. The problem of water depletion can be partly solved by checking the wastage of water, reusing water, waste water if possible, storing water from dry season, diverting surplus water from wet regions or dry regions, and rainwater harvesting. You have to write the starting from here till here. Okay. Now see the next question. Now see the question number 5. What is soil profile? And your answer is? Your answer is given on page number 10. The different layers of soil are known as horizons. The complete vertical sequence of horizons is known as soil profile. Okay. This was your answer number 5. Now see the next question, that is question number 6. What is arable land? How much of India's land is arable? And your answer is about 1/3 of world's land is arable, which is suitable for growing crops. Less than 1/3 of under forest. About 1/4 are comprised of pastures and the rest of either used for other purposes or is unproductive. Okay, so this was your answer number 6. Now see the next question. You have to cut question number 7 and 8. Now see the question number 9. Explain how eco-friendly methods can control soil pollution. And your answer is, your answer is given on page number 13, third paragraph. Soil pollution by chemicals can be reduced by using natural enemies of pests instead of pesticides and natural manures instead of chemical fertilizers. This was your answer number 5. Now see the last question. Briefly describe any 3 methods of soil conservation. And your answer was given on page number 13. Conservation. Afforestation is very effective in checking soil erosion in steepy slopes. Terrain tracing helps control soil erosion on gentle slopes. Contour plowing or lines joining points of equal elevations checks erosion. Embankments of soil and rocks may be built along the contour and check the flow of rainwater down slopes. To hold the barriers in places, grasses and other vegetation may be planted on them. So there are 2 points are given over here, and now see the next point, that is, farmers can be reduced soil erosion from their fields by covering plowed soil or soil left bare after a harvest. This is known as mulching. Dried vegetation, straw and discarded parts of the harvested crop and some of their things commonly used as mulch. Substance used to cover the bare soil. So we have completed the question answer of chapter number 2 of geography, and in our next class we will do the exercises of this chapter.